That holds my life. We're saying you are the pillar, Lord. You are the pillar that holds my life.
Always thank Jesus as the sweetest name I know. Oh, it's always strength. I am the reason why I love Him so Jesus
is the sweetest thing I know. Oh, He's always just the same God. So praise His holy name. And that is the reason why I love Him so much. Jesus, He's the sweetest name I know. I sing Jesus, Jesus, the Lord, Jesus. Oh, you are. Lord. He is the Lord.
Hello. Please, as you continue with your meals, I would want you to take this opportunity to introduce some special people that we have in our midst. We now have our very own president, Mr. Robert Boyfield, in our midst. Uncle Bob, give us a wave. We also have director for Zone 1, Sir Kwaku Baini. Uncle Baini. Thank you. Then we also have our very frequent visiting pastor, Pastor Mist. A wave, please. Then there's one point that I skipped, which I would want to bring back. I would want to specially welcome everyone who is here for the first time. Can you give me a wave? Those who are visiting us for the first time. Thank you so much for honoring the invitation. I would now want to call on my sister, Catherine Metal, to give us number.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
You're all welcome. Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International. Who are we? Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International is the world's largest Christian businessmen organization, networking thousands of members in more than 142 nations through over 7,000 local chapters. Besides providing a forum for contact, sharing experiences, and exchange of ideas and fellowship values in the markets, in communities, and the homes. We are businessmen and professionals who have come to discover the value of God in our lives in every personal way. We love to share and enrich our life exchanging experience together. We are full gospel because we believe in the Bible. That is God's word to us that can challenge, inspire, equip, guide insight into God and His values and His kingdom. We believe and demonstrate the power of God in our lives and miracle, healing, speaking in tongues, and powerful deliverances. Businessmen, we are becoming extraordinary through the power of the Holy Spirit. The group was started when Demos Shaka, who was from Armenian background and living in the USA, saw a lack of men involved in Christian work. God gave him a vision to see men mobilized and equipped to be the men God called and destined them to be. As he was a businessman, he reached other businessmen with the good news that God wants for them and loves them. His main vision was to see men involved in this and other Christian work. To equip ladies to reach other ladies with the good news about the love of God. A group of people who love to get together and witness the love, the compassion, the reality of Jesus Christ. We meet, work, and pray together, usually in a friendly environment, mainly in restaurants over a meal. It is a platform for those who want to find out more about the Christian faith and other than a church building. International, we aim to reach the whole world, all flesh, a deep concern for every nation and every race. The original vision that Demos had was of normal, everyday people standing shoulder to shoulder around the world, united as God's people, bringing hope and love to a needy world. Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International is now in over 142 nations with hundreds of thousands of members and supports. What we do? Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International tries to reach people with the gospel of Jesus Christ by means of personal testimony, speaking about experiences in the place of work. Local meetings or chapters are organized regularly where members and non-members can come together, usually at a restaurant or hotel, and share experiences and encourage one another in the Christian faith. Mission: to reach men in all nations for Jesus Christ, to call men back to God, to help believers to be baptized in the Holy Spirit and to grow spiritually, to train and equip men to fulfill the great mission, to provide opportunity for Christian fellowship, to bring a greater unity among all people in the body of Christ. Vision: a vast global movement of labor comprising men and women being used mightily by God to bring this last great harvest through the outpouring of God's Holy Spirit before the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. Membership dues: members, $100. Women, $50. Renewable members: men, 50 Ghana cedis, and women, 30 Ghana cedis. Our meeting days: every Tuesday between 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. at the Grand Presbytery. Weekly seminars. Monthly outreach meeting: fourth Saturday of every month at Novotel Hotel, 9 o'clock a.m. to 11 o'clock a.m. Ladies and gentlemen, you are all invited to join the happiest people on earth. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sister Catherine. Just a little to what she said. Membership renewal is yearly. For men, it's 50 Ghana cedis, and for ladies, it's 30 Ghana cedis. Please, as you are, just tilt your chair and then be facing the high table. Those who are done, you just can tilt and then face us here. Then I would also want to add this to say that for anyone to be a member, you go through a short induction, which after the induction you pay your membership fee and then you are pinned. So there is a pinning ceremony which we are going to witness one this morning. We will be calling our brother Seth to join me. He will be pinned this morning. Yes. Shall we please have the honor of our zone director, Mr. Kwekubaini, to do the morning. Thank you. Please put your hands together for him as he is coming. Yes.
I'm always glad when I'm called upon to do this. This morning, we are not in. This is a pin, a symbol of remembrance. A pin that will always call our brother back on track. That he is no more where he used to be, and that he's changed camp. He now belongs to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. But you see, as I always say, this is not for decoration. This is to remind you of your new assignment, of bringing men back to Christ, of doing whatever the six objectives. My brother, pleasure is mine this morning to bring you into our fold. Unfortunately, we were brought up that way. It's between the two of us. So I'm giving that to you in addition to this. Always make it a point to remember that also. And I tell you, you move on to places. I would want Auntie Kukua. Oh, you, I've also done the same thing to you. Please come. You are not going to talk. Don't worry. You pin him for me.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
In the name of the Father.
Uncle.
Yes.
In the name. It's not going.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
Okay. Okay.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so grateful for a time like this. We thank you, Father, for the renewal of that soul and the life of this one, even as he's been pinned. Father, we ask in the name of Jesus that let this always be a remembrance to him, that he can never look back. I ask in the name of Jesus that, Father, even as he's come to join the fold, let the pillar of cloud and the pillar of fire protect him by day and by night. I pray in the name of Jesus that, Father, from today, he will see the difference because you are with him. I also pray in the name of Jesus that even as he's come to join us, let it not be for decoration, but let him always remember. Let him always remember. Let him always remember that you come first. And that what makes you happy is always to get people back to fold. I ask in the name of Jesus that shall be his priority in life. That shall be his priority in life. And in the end, you'll be careful to give you the praise. We thank you, Father, for answering our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Kindly do me the honor of... This is the Voice Magazine. And this is... the mission and the vision. I was trying to talk to you about it. So at all times, go through and...
In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, do we give this to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Please, welcome to the fold.
You're welcome. This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
Thank you very much, Sebaini and Auntie Kukua. Thank you so much. One of the hallmark of full gospel business men fellowship, which we cannot do without, and if it hadn't been part of this program, we wouldn't be here today. That is testimony. We really, really thrive on testimony. So this very moment, I would want to call on Auntie Joyce Amponsa to give us the first testimony.
There couldn't have been any better time for me to give a testimony than this month and today, because it marks exactly 1 year when I was invited to Businessmen Fellowship in this very auditorium. I am the fourth born of five children, born to a typical country and adulterous home. Growing up, we were religion of believed in the African black white man. So it was in his home being this. But I started attending SU and I realized that there was a room and that of man's God. But that would not work because it was that of my school fees and daily upkeep. So until I got to Form 3, that was when I actually accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior. And I was in the faith until I finished O-level and actually began very active in church. My father would not have any which he calls tongues. Unfortunately, God visited me mightily and he used me in so many ways that I had so much gift since I didn't know what to do. And so it was very, very difficult practicing my father's religion as against the religion of the white man. That's how he called it. So it was like that. We were struggling until I got to the polytechnic and after school, started speaking to my father's adulterous life, and that was the beginning of my troubles. I was banished from home because I had no right to tell him how many women he can go out with. And I started struggling in life because then I had no other means of surviving. But I fended for myself by just trying to do menial jobs for friends who had married then. Until I got a job a year after national service and I actually was posted to Y in the northern region. And that was where I lived for a very long time. So fast forward, 2012 was my year when I began to journey to Golgotha. What were the issues? Three things were eating me up. First, I resigned an international job to take up a project. Powers that be will not let me be because apparently I had been chosen over somebody's favorite. And so the frustration and the anxiety was very great up to a point that I couldn't really bear it anymore. As if that was not enough, I also had persecution from my church place and a group of ladies just tried to out of the church. And unfortunately, this gang was led by my own cousin with whom I lived in the same house. Well, I started asking God, is it him or is it somebody else? Then to crown it all, in 2012, it was discovered that I had fibroid and I had to operate it. And I went through the surgery successfully, but not against the doctor's advice that I should get pregnant 6 months after. This didn't go down well with my parents at all because my mother thought I was aging and she needed grandchildren, and so was my father. So the pressure was on. Three places: work, home, church. It was not easy at all. And then my mother would wake me up almost every dawn to remind me that 6 months had passed. It's a tough decision to actually not just marry, but it was also pressure to have children outside marriage. And I thought to myself, I have served this God all these years. What will people say? Because I was not just a dormant Christian. I was everywhere and everybody knew that I had a stand and my religion was the white man God and it could not be any other thing. So then my father began to pressure me that I had to do this deporting, the guns call it otofo, which he thought would bring me the breakthrough to marriage. And so another war also began. It was for Christ or for the black African God. I managed to survive, but it was not easy at all. At this point, I realized that I was losing my faith and I had lost peace. I had lost joy. I had lost everything because there was no... If you go to work, there was frustration. When you come home, there was frustration. When you go to church, there was frustration. So I thought that I wanted to run far away to somewhere else where I could change place or something supernatural should happen to me. It was within this period that I met, well, I knew her already, but she actually invited me to Full Gospel. So when I came, it was a meeting like this. The atmosphere was serene. The presence was mighty. The people looked like angels. And I actually enjoyed the service. And so I did not hesitate at all to respond to the altar call when it was called. and I just joined the fellowship outright without any pressures from anywhere. And I can say on authority that after I joined Full Gospel, I got my joy back, I got my peace back, I got everything I wanted back. And I also want to say that this is not just a group of people, but it's a fellowship that actually makes impact. And when you meet the people and you interact with them, you know that these are people that are sent from God. And I want to urge every one of you, especially the president, who has a peculiar way of calling me Joyce. And I also enjoy the warmth of Dr. and Mrs. Buckman's greetings. From time to time, they'll call you on the phone and ask how you are doing. And I also enjoy the praise from Mr. Bading all the time when he will meet you and say, "Hey, Joyce, you never called me." And above all, I want to say special thank you to Dr. Hila and his wife, who would never hesitate to call me any day I do not attend breakfast meeting. Not only will they call me, but they also support me financially anytime I need any medical help. And I want to say to you all that God bless you richly for this opportunity to join this wonderful fellowship. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, Auntie Joyce. He said we all look like angels, and I believe you look like angels this morning. It's lovely. Can we have a second testimony from our brother, Robert?
Good morning. Good morning. Pastor Robert Kwabena, and I'm the firstborn of my parents. I have three other siblings. I grew up from a strong community. That's Mamobi. When I was a small boy, I wanted to be a Muslim. I was very close to my mom. Always my mom called me and said, "Robert, don't be a Muslim. You're on the right path." When I hear this, I encourage my own self. 2006, I've always been closer to my mom. My mom called me. She was like, "Robert, you're going to write me." And the whole clan, not just the family, the whole clan. None of you have passed an exam before, but I'm sure God will see you through. When she said this, it introduced a lot of fear in me. Then I said, wow, if none of them have passed, then I have to give my life to Christ so that he can favor me. So in March 2007, 25th, that was Saturday, I intentionally gave my life to Christ. Then I went to my BC, waiting for my results. I was helping my mom. My mom was baking and selling bread. So I was helping her baking and we're selling the bread. The results came, I have passed. I showed the results to my mom. My mom said, "Hey, Robert, you are going to secondary school that belongs to the rich people. You can go. Sit down, sit home and help me in the bed." I said, "Oh, mom, I can't go there." She convinced me that I should sit home. So I was sitting home for some time until one Muslim man who was an allergy, he heard my incidents. He decided to enroll me at Accra High School. When I went to Accra High School, I decided to take God more serious. So I joined Scripture Union. I became vice president. Then, by the grace of God, I finished my exams. I completed successfully. I applied to some universities and polytechnics. When I came, I got an admission at economics. I showed the results to my mom, but then we've lost our dad. My mom said, "Robert, university belongs to the rich children. Sit home." I convinced and struggled with her. She said, "Okay, fine. I've done my best, but I can get half of the bills. I can't settle it. So you relax. Going to school is not a race. Relax, next year, I will take you." I was so much convinced by her words. So I relaxed. I sat home. I was working by then, teaching these small teachings. The next year, I reapplied. I was given the admission at Legon and Accra Polytechnic. She saw that. She said, "Robert, it seems the bills has increased. Relax, next year we'll go." I was, what kind of... So I didn't listen to her. I just have to enroll myself. She helped me a little bit. I enrolled myself at a crypto technic to study HND in accounting. But you see, something happened. When I go to a crypto link, the man of God, I had the conviction, the feeling within me that I'll be withdrawn. Coincidentally, I went to my opportunity to register as a new student. And I heard him yelling at some ladies that go home, go ahead, that you've been withdrawn. I thought the man was talking to me. I thought the man, I was so much in fear. I spent the rest of my life on campus living in fear. I have to learn like a mad dog because I fear. And I have to pray because I fear. I joined PENSA. I became PENSA finance officer. In 2013, something terrible happened. I realized that God doesn't love me. For me, dear, God doesn't love me. So I have to just at least do something so that he can show me a little bit mercy because he doesn't love me. It was when, within a month, through the interval, two people had to die in my family. That's my grandmother. It's exactly 2 years my mom passed away. In fact, I was so much under stress. I fell sick. My roommates had to rush me to the school clinic. They checked my blood pressure. They said my blood pressure is 56/100. And the way the doctor too was scared. I never knew anything about this. He was scared me with words. Have you been receiving broken heart or so many things? I was so much under stress. But then I was praying. I knew that, oh God, you know, but I have to do something so you have a little bit favor on me. When my mom was being buried on that very fateful day of the funeral, my friends were coming. I was very popular on campus because I used to represent them on quizzes, and they were coming to the funeral. I was there. I got a call that some of the boys has gotten an accident. I said, this one was confirmed. God, me, I know you hate me, but you just show me a little bit favor. By the grace of God, none of them died. I was so much popular on campus because of this accident issue. I was so much popular. And after the funeral, after everything, I graduated by the grace of God with first class. But before leaving the school, I was very close to one lecturer. He called me, Robert. He said, Robert, come. I know you're a brilliant boy. You're a good boy. If you want to be rich, if you want to be popular, stop going to church. But when I finished with my last paper, you know, one thing that I always thank God was, my mom helped me pay my final fees before dying. So I said, Robert, stop going to church. I want to groom you. I want to take you to China to top up. What the heck? China said, wow. He said, but you have to be a... Then I said to him, okay, give me some time to go and think about it. I don't want to tell my friends and my loved ones. So I was just thinking about this. I started the service. I was so blessed to find you. I always call Avenger. God bless you. As a co-worker, and he's a kind of person, even if he's telling me, Joe, I want to stay God, he will say, pray first. I quite remember I told him, Joe, this is what is going on. The government is not paying us, and I have siblings that I have to feed them. I need money. I want to go for this business option. Joe said, pray to God. I said, Joe, how can you tell me to go and pray to God, tell him God that God, I want to backslide. So in March, I was so much in stress. In March, I sneaked to the lecture and they finalized everything. That in April or May, I was just out of the country. I'll not tell anyone. I'll just call my siblings when they tell them, and check, sending them some money. That was what I was having in mind. Then I said, after all, people do backslide, then they come back. So if I should backslide for 1 year and come back, the value is the same. So I went to the man. I did everything, but I had to move in April. This is a demonstration. So I thank you so much because of the way he carried himself at the workplace, and he gave me an invite. I said, this guy, this free gospel, you go, they preach, they talk. We these prayers, we pray now, we are tired. Well, let me come to praise him. So I came, and when I came, one perfect man was sharing the word, perfect, was sharing the word. He said he has been in his room for more than 19 years. When I heard this, I was, wow. I asked myself, Robert, can you be in his room for 3 years? Think your future is bright. Now, going through all of the small things, you think God doesn't love you. Then I said to myself, that no, I have to stand. I don't have to give up. So, actually, when I came, I was fully convinced that my future would be great. So I decided my option. So I stayed. I think my time is up. I don't want to talk too much. There is a saying that a great talker is a liar. But I want to tell you something. You see, when you read the Bible says that in Psalm 66 verse 12, it says, they said, I have passed through waters. I have passed through fires. But he brought us to a place of abundance. This morning, my message I want to leave to you that, I don't know, maybe you are going through waters. You are going through to a place of abundance. I have received so many benefits as a result of joining Full Gospel, and I can fully convince that I'm fully convinced that Full Gospel is through Christ. God bless you.
Thank you so much, Robert. Thank you so much. I believe you all agree with me that for any society, any organization to thrive, one aspect of it is money, funds. So this morning, I just would want to appeal to you that, you know, this big fast meeting that we are having and our meetings, Full Gospel is not a money-making venture. We don't have any investment. We don't sell or buy anything. But we do all these things out of what you offer or you give to us in the form of donations, offerings, and pledges. Before you on the table, you have envelopes and pledge forms. I would want you to dip your hands into your pocket and then support this worthy cause, where your funds will provide for this breakfast. Your funds will allow us to meet and fulfill the missions of Full Gospel and the missions of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we will have a quick offering. Put something in that envelope, but please don't seal it because we recycle the envelopes to use another time. God bless you. Can we have a music to go along with us?
Bye.
Thank you very much, Royal Break. Shall we bow our heads for over the offertory? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you that you are a great provider. For what we have sown on your land, it is the seed given us by your hand. Therefore, we thank you for it. We pray that this seed is sown on your fertile ground and your spirit will water it and cause it to germinate and increase. Bless every pocket that this seed came out of and let your name be glorified in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. On your program, next is worship, but I would want to take this opportunity to introduce the man I skipped, because the worship would be a form of introduction which will usher all of us before the presence of God, and then he will slip in after the worship. I have a short biography of this special guest that we have this morning that I would want to read out before I mention his name. This man is an internationally acclaimed speaker, best-selling author, spiritual mentor, relationship consultant, and motivational lecturer. He is also known for his practical application of wisdom, knowledge, and power from kingdom principles through his books, conferences, prayer, rallies, and ministry to men. He continues to reach men globally, challenging and changing them to fulfill their potential for true manhood, which is leadership. Many have listened to and studied his principle. He is considered by many as the father of today's men's movement in sub-Saharan Africa. He now travels extensively worldwide to strengthen men, leaders, and churches under the divine guidance of the Holy Spirit. His ambition in life is to positively impact and transform over 1 million young men of African descent by the year 2020. He lives in Buckinghamshire in England with his wife Patricia and children Charles John Jr. and Silalis Jada. This man is in the person of no other one than Dr. Charles Buckman. Shall we put our hands together for him? But before I hand over the microphone to him, I would want us to have a short worship to usher all of us, to prepare us for the word that he is going to give. God is going to speak through him to us this morning. Let me in the presence of God before he comes to the podium. Thank you.
Yeah, alone, and it's you and you alone, Father. We bless your name. We lift your name.
Everybody, clap your hands, the glory of God. Before you sit down, the song, there's a song, learn it quickly. I'm learning so many songs again, but that one, could you? Let's sing it, raise up your hand, lift up your
hand.
It all belongs to you. The Bible said that unto you shall the saints be. But most importantly, you said, for there you command your blessing. This morning, the next few minutes, sing. Let a life be saved. Let a life be impacted. Somebody change because and Lord, we thank you for what you've done for us. In Jesus' name, and everybody shall say amen. Well, clap your hands and give God praise. Be seated. Good. It's interesting, but full gospel impacted lives beyond our comprehension. As a candidate, I was testifying that led me to Christ, Mr. Akwesi Amwakohene. Can you believe this? So many years ago, and then Donald.
This is a demonstration.
The devil has messed this country up so much. The people, they are defying weapons they even carry. By the amount of bodyguards that walk around them as a man of God. Heaven and earth is coming, and we're all going to give account for what we have to do. Are you with me? Today I decided another decided college person that I'm so grateful. We know 40 something years ago that today in this room read anything that you went through. Amen. Because God has a plan. I said God has a plan. Amen. The Bible says all things work together for his good. And those that are called according to his purpose. So God had a purpose. From my desire to call it the time we're growing now, I mean, my short testimony is a big testimony, but I'll make it short. What it was like in those days, I grew up and told me never God knows what he was doing. He didn't want people this country, but to be back, and I God said he took us out to bring us in. Stand God came that I'm supposed to location. Listen, for the land of my pulpit or anywhere I speak, something I tell you, say, go location, and even the Jamaicans were telling me, so what you thought the location. So I have this passion for Cape Town. My music department, they're from South Africa, and they're from Cape Town, and they come. I had this sentimental, it was not spiritual attached, it was sentimental. My very and Jonathan Butler, because he tells me about Cape. So I love Cape Town. Until one day, current Cape Coast chief, who was my dad's mentee. So love trying to, my dad died when I was very young. Daddy died when I was 21 ways to be a father. Because I know what it is like to grow up without a father. I hate people when they tell and give up and we suffered. Come on, don't we love those things. Listen, God, you must be grateful for whatever. Am I making sense? Mommy always found the school fees. Never our parents sacrificed for us to be where we are today. So I refuse to say we suffered. What was the suffering? So we left. I decided it was good, everything. But I had an encounter, three encounters that finally now give my heart to the Lord. And those encounters, the one, you remember the time when history of that school that has been dismissed and brought back in 3 weeks. God had a plan. Everybody say God had a plan. We went to a place, remember Big Apple? You can tell the like Bastilus, Bastilus, and God Big Apple. So the headmaster said, Buckman, and look, where Buckman came run out. When I go to, I jump into my bed. Roll call, you know that big bell, bang, bang, and the guy not, I was not there, but he said, you, I saw you. I said, you saw me where? they said, I should mention the other, as for Jay and those guys. I said, was alone. He says, for being, I mean, they tried Bishop me from the board because my father was, but they had to, so they fired me. I frustrated that man till he left. Mr. Some man, Mr. Okai, man, he said, boom, my daddy comes to see my mother. I used to flat. I don't know what took place there, but I had to go back to Adisado. My brother left about 50 years. Nobody remembers him. In breaking news, PV are being by God, it's not only for good things. Come on, hear me. Of God, come on. And when God blesses you, it adds no sorrow. Yes. I had a house in Trazako, but he can't sleep in, so he called. I finished my school, my degree. How? So I said, this thing is not right. The church just backtrack a little bit. We went, I left, came back, and I had some friends. Again, we're partying. Like party, he would tell you, man, we Salam them. Obey, that was my nickname. Maybe I be cool. My words, maybe I be cool. Like, you know, mothers have a way of. Just sprayed all of them. Do you know up to today? But before he mentioned my name. So I waited till 5 in the morning. You know those stocks was not knowing my destiny was in the making. So the police soldiers came. That was the most, that was the worst school in Ghana. When if you now looking for my guys in all this ocean of bodies, then I found John. You grow when you number when you number two, and I saw the security guy. This oh, so what is that? That TV show, Mrs. Ah, good. TV show is off. Yeah, what a very good buzz. Yeah, I saw for you. I saw for you. I saw for 80. Yeah, what type of any? Then can Williams if any? I said, really? Now, that's the quarter me. I could defend and I said, Ghana, even my driver volunteers information. When so. Can I see them? How can you? Can someone identify what I'm saying? Because you don't do that. So he showed me all the pastors, their homes. He said, hey, wait here. Within 10 minutes, the guy had told me who lives. That's Ghana for you. So when at the funeral, when I passed the family, it's like they're saying, boo. You know, and like I'm a good mini, but you know, I don't understand. They didn't know I could speak Ghana. Like mango team, mammy. Then somebody, then so guess who helped me? Harry Zako. He had a club called Bastop. I got Boki because we used to do, I like football, Olympics, Agosu. Me and Salim, my cousin. I was like the secretary to Agosu. Bobo, a machine. Is there a God? To joke, all of them, with University Primary School, Kofi. So, pray with him. Then we went to a place called Reverend Agbozo, if you remember him. It was the beach side. Building power. We did an all night. My first all night. I've never, all night was in the Cave de Roy, but this all night was proper what? Then we prayed, and I gave my heart to the Lord. Guess what Harry did next? Harry Zako bought me a ticket and took me back to England. So I always salute Harry Zako. I never forget him. You need to acknowledge where you've come from. Don't forget God. And also acknowledge the people that helped you get to where you were. So I always mention him. So last Saturday was a very important time. And today is another important. So I gave my heart. Then the rest is history. God called me in England. And I didn't know nothing. Trust me. When we started the ministry, don't let nobody deceive you. When God calls you, he progressively grows you. So when they come, so when I see 22-year-old boys and 25 running churches, I laugh. You're only running on exuberance. Look at the disciple. It took them years. It took Paul 15 years to walk with the disciples until he became an apostle. Am I making sense? Yes. So life in kingdom principles, you got to learn. There are seven kingdom principles. Number one, the first kingdom principle, the principle of organization. Everybody say organization. You see, when God created the world, the first thing he did was he organized the world. When your life is not organized, it's like distortion of purpose. You're every day, what life in you're messed up. It's just because your purpose is distorted. You're confused. But when you organize, take a step back, stand, cut people off. Last week, I told some guys in a meeting, take 3 days, 72 hours. Take 3 days before the year ends. I didn't say fast. Just cut everybody off. Relax, get yourself back again and rethink. That's the topic for today. Rethinking your priorities in life. Amen?
Amen.
The next kingdom principle is sowing and reaping. It's a principle. You sow. Whatever you sow, you do what? You reap. The principle of faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. But you get the book and the tape. But so Harry took me, then I started ministry. I didn't know nothing. So guess who? Here was I. Me, like God in the ministry, within a short, boom! Because of my personality. Do you follow? Holy Spirit will use your personality. Doesn't mean it was you. It's a matter. The Holy Spirit will use your personality to do something. Because that's what he does best, to convict people. One of the things you got to learn fast, everybody say conviction. Say preference. You see, in life, you are either convicted about something. When you go to church, people are either convicted to be in Christ or they prefer. People are, so somebody say, I go to ICGC, you know, because they prefer to be around there. You see, somebody can talk you out of your preference, but nobody can talk you out of your conviction. It's like marriage. If you're convicted about who you married, nobody can talk about it. It's like business. Whatever you're convicted about, it would work because you know what you're about. And so many people are not convicted about their salvation because they came by need, were driven by a need. That's okay. God works with that. But along the line, you must be convicted. And then conversion comes in. Am I making sense? When you convert, it's a different ballgame. Good God Almighty, you begin to do wonders. And so that's what happened to me. It was difficult. But then God opened the door. I met a man called Bishop Fua. Now he's a bishop. I wasn't a bishop then. Then he says his friend is Duncan Williams. This is 1983. 1983. Duncan Williams had never traveled. So I said, bring him. I want to learn. So we arranged and brought Duncan Williams. Then he came to teach me. I learned so much from Nicholas Duncan Williams, how to pray. Oh my God. He said, Bucky, if you don't pray, you will stay. If you don't fast, you will last. You have to pray. Give Nicholas Duncan a big hand. Clap his. Because on your journey of salvation, God will bring people to help you. I said, God will bring people to help you. And then God gave me favor with a friend of mine called Kofi Banfo. He was working with Michael Bassett in Victory Church. So when they got all the big speakers, the Copelands and what that, then I lived in the east end of London then. So the church, when they finished, they come and preach for me. So everybody thought, wow, Bucky has got big connections, bringing all these big, but it was favor. Everybody say favor.
Yeah.
Favor is God speaking about you to somebody. That's what favor is. God telling somebody about you. As the life went on, and it was so good, ministry was great. I was traveling today. Just 2 days ago, I was looking at my passport. I've been to 42 nations preaching the gospel. Come on, give the Lord a hug. I am so excited. I'm so excited about life. And I said, God, thank you. Favor in England. Then I met Her Majesty Patricia Adocho Brown of Simpe. My life changed when I met my wife here in Ghana. I came to do some work with ICGC. Dr. Otavio, we met in Bahamas. And then he said, oh, Charlie, your day be your day be my mother had died, my father had died. You know, life, you don't know where you fit in, because I spent most of my adult life in England. I don't know how, when I come here, the way things were, I didn't get it. I didn't know my father had a plan for me. So I came to Ghana. To get married to a lady, it didn't work out. Sometimes it doesn't work out. You're not wrong. Nobody's wrong. She's not wrong. I'm not wrong. It just didn't work out. Leave the rest to God. Am I making sense?
Yes.
It didn't work out. Then I was so distraught. Oh my God. This woman made me do so many things. I got a house and everything. It was Sakumono, where the barrier is.
So I was, my neighbors, God Never Never, CK, all those guys who used to hang out. And they used to, you know, I remember one time there was a guy called Vincent Assisi. You all remember him?
Yeah.
He was my neighbor, was behind me. And then there's another joke. You just, and then he said he's written a book about Rawlings. So we should come and he's going to launch it at the place called Golden Tulip. But he wants me to come and do the launch. So he had written the program. Reverend C.J. Buckman from England. Then he put at the end, Archbishop Duncan Williams will bring the closing prayer. And I knew when you put them in trouble. So, so when we went to show the program, this is Archbishop. Is that Bokma? Rondo? Bucky? He's a boy of God. He's not a man of God. He's my boy. That's the first time I heard a boy of God. That's my son. How can I sit down for my son to preach? And I sit down. Do you understand kingdom protocol? The man was shaking. He changed the program. And so when I arrived at the program, because President Rawlings and all those big guys were there, then this is Duncan Williams. He was preaching and I arrived. That's my son. Give him a big hand. So he may want to make you know, but I know him. That's how he is. It doesn't change me. Listen, nothing changes. When you know God and know who you are, people's opinions never affect you.
Yes.
Never live your life to please anybody but God.
Yes.
Am I making sense, ladies and gentlemen? Your ministry, your call, whatever you do, do it as unto the
Lord.
So I was disappointed. I said, Lord, you didn't love me. Charlie, this woman, and that's the mistake many of us do. You know what? Everybody was looking for a wife for me but myself. Auntie Kwa will come and tell him, Abi, I don't go neban may in aka of you Canada by a doctor. Anyway, my phone. Because when my mother died, she became our mother. And so my can't chan but I'm gonna ban and by my can't you every day. And so back and so I find a universe no I'm Canada because I'm can or a doctor. Now what Toronto, well our Toronto is a then my big sister will come. Abi, Missy Obio. Hey, Miss Odigo Papa. I said, "Oti they preach." Then you are joking. Meanwhile, my sister has got money from her. See, they. And Tiffy gets all her medicine from Canada and all her money. See, Abeku walen 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 walen. Many of you fall for that. Don't let anybody choose a wife for you. Because when they choose for you, you are forever enslaved to them. You know why? Because every, especially if they are Ghanaians, well, may the Lord deliver us. Also, I didn't. So I went home. I mean, sometimes I'll be at home. I'll be at home. Then she'll deliberately bring a lady. Everybody park here. When my mom meet to know that I'll drive car. Georgina park here now. I'll be at home. When Merchant, my mom, you know. And she was always in my house. Sometimes when I come and meet some ladies, I mean, these are top class, top flight ladies, high brow, high maintenance women. They just come and say, you're in my kitchen, man. Where is, but you know, hello. Hi. And then you see Auntie go up here. Hey, I'll be. Have you seen our mothers? Why are you here? Never ever. Trust me. So I was even the one that made a mistake was my sister, Yvonne told me she was a good girl, not that we see. Anyway, so okay. I forgive because I love you for my only sister. I love her dearly. So I went to tell Dr. Otabi Chale, how to go. This to not be for me. Ghana is not for me. I'm gone. Maybe I should stay in England. You know, when you're dejected, you don't. Then, but prior to that, I'd had a row. Not a row. When I came to the place, she was the secretary of Dr. Otabio, my wife. And when I said, excuse me, my name is Buckman. I'm from England. I'm here to see Dr. Otabio. Do you have an appointment? I said, do you think I'll leave England and come and stand up? I didn't know that in Ghana, that's what you do. But in England, you can't go to Obinna office squad. You must have a reason. So I, hey, check. So we started, we had a banter. And Doc came to settle it. Oh, you be. Mara, my fault. So I passed. So when I finished the 7 minutes and everything, I was going. I said I needed to make up with her. Can you believe the woman that I was? Troll energy. So I went back to her and I said, baby, I'm sorry. I brought, you know, typical friend, number two, can I swear? Into, we brought chocolates and all that just to say sorry. Timbuko, I was going straight to the airport from there. But when I shook her hand, I said, hey, something happened. I said, baby, are you married? She said, who wants to know? I said, you're still being saucy. She said, who wants to know? I said, yeah, you're married. She said, who wants to know? I said, I'm just asking. Have you got a boyfriend? She said, no. I said, you live working here. You don't have a boyfriend. This church of about 5,000. She says, no. I said, okay. Hasta la vista. I'll be back to marry you. 9 months later, she was my wife. God set it up. Everybody say, God set it up. You see, so when God sets it up, you don't even, it just comes. Trust me, your business will fall in place. Everything will fall in place because God set it up. Because you are just one conversation away from your miracle. Amen. Throughout the Bible, read about Christ. Every miracle that Christ performed was a conversation. May you have the right conversation. Amen. May you be sensitive to the person. Sometimes breakthroughs are coming, business opportunities are coming, but you are all over the place in your mind. Your spirit is not at rest. And so you don't even know. God's blessing doesn't come packaged in some... Do you follow? It comes on you. You don't even see it. Look at the place I found my destiny. Today, after years of people mocking me, I don't have children. She's given me two beautiful children. Two beautiful children. That's how God works. Do you follow what I'm saying? And God has used that to stabilize my life. Yes, every woman has a purpose in your life. Are you with me? Ladies, when your time comes, be what God wants you to be in your husband's life. Amen. And so she helped me. I married Patricia not because of love. Love is there. Everybody's love, 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 love. Even Tina knows. He said, what love got to do with it? But what is important, what was important was that she was faithful. And I said, if she could be faithful to Dr. Tabi for 18 years as a PA, it means she can be faithful to me. Do you understand what I'm saying? And so I want to close with these few points that I made just sitting down there. I noticed there's a problem. There's a challenge. When you come into a city, you ask God to help you. Why I'm here? My number one ambition in life is to touch the next generation of leaders and young people. Because what they've seen is not what they should go with. The nonsense and the chaos that we've been in. I was in a conference in Brussels, Burkina Bay. I go there to talk. You see, I went everywhere but Ghana. I don't know what happened to me. I will travel everywhere, but it's like there was a force that didn't want me to come. When I come, 3 days, the maximum I've been in Ghana is 5 days, I'm gone. It's like and there's thousands like me abroad. There's a spirit that is holding people back who have gamut experience to come and add to what you have, and we make a dynamic change this nation. I am so proud of the full gospel as we've started this thing on praying for the nation, call to repentance. It is so true that this country must repent. How many of you understand what I'm talking about? We must turn around from our wicked ways. The church and the people at large, not all Christians at large. Listen to me. When God says my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, it is so true. How many of you know the 2 Chronicles 7:14? Remember that scripture? If my people that are called by my name, number one, will turn from their what? We are so wicked Christians. A Christian will sit in front of you. He's got what you need, but he'll give you a story. That's wickedness. That is spiritual wickedness. The Bible said, do not hold good from... How many of you have been in a position where you know this brother can help you, but he's giving you a story? These days, I've learned the way out. When I ask you for help, and you don't give me, say, oh, shuffle, or I know, miss, let it be according to your word. The best thing to say is, this, brother, on this occasion, I cannot assist you due to circumstances beyond my... Words are... powerful. A brother in my church, the wife gave £5,000 towards a bill, like you're collecting. In England, we don't build out, we rent. So renting a hotel, and we haven't paid for some time. Like now, I'm not there. You follow? So it's like I hate what has happened. God is transforming our church. The church was built around my personality, and that's a failure. This is a demonstration. I don't know that you get what I'm saying. So if I'm back to Abra, so now Mumba 1 year. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
So that's why when God called me on an apostolic ministry to travel around the nations, you don't know how glad I was. Because it's like, if I miss church one day, some of them will phone. Right now, they are listening. We're streaming this live. So I don't act like they should listen. Wouldn't say, I'm an American. wherever I go, but because I'll be away for about 3 months now, so wherever I speak, they gather. The way we have a radio on internet radios in the church, so those who are working and cleaning are listening, those by phone and everything. That's technology. That's how I'm going to reach the million. I don't have to be everywhere, but every country, we'll talk about another time. But I realized that there's a force in this country. We are so wicked to each other. Oh, it's quiet in the Methodist church. We don't want to help each other, but God is transforming us. There's a generation growing up that would help each other. Do you understand what I'm saying? We would assist each other in every little way. This gentleman, Fanti man, that's what annoyed me. He's a Fanti man. The wife is an Ashanti girl. She comes up to the... She says I should stop raising the offering, but she will pay over cover. That will ye mama raise... Then she said, okay. So she whispered to me she will give £5,000. I didn't want the mumbo ninchu, so I should do a breakdance. I said, are you sure? She said, oh, all right, so forth. Give our Ashanti sisters a big hand. And so she came at home. I said, but go and tell your husband and bring it with your husband. Hey, I don't want trouble. The brother is from KP, my own brother. So Wednesday, the people have told the people bringing the check on Wednesday. Charlie, Wednesday, money no come. So I said, bro, what's up? Listen to what Pakwesi told me. Hey, so for, project. And the woman came up. So I called her to say, it's okay. I thought she was feeling bad. That's why she hasn't called me. She says, no. Ah, are they? So I said, hey, oye, munya mumbra, my office. So they all came. Pakwesi, yes, and Antoine. Pakwesi, I'm talking about Christian, Ghanaian, how we behave, that is wrong. So I said, Abba, someone, ah, now question, the man, please can I call Ghana? She can I me passbook. How did you, it's her own private savings. So he said, hey, now what you mean, you didn't trust, sir? What again are you hiding from me? I say, hey, please. did you all get it?
Yes.
The point I'm trying to establish is that let's be free in our spirit in the church to serve and work for the ministry. Because every soul that we touch, you never know. You never know. You never know who will walk in here and be saved. What he will do, not just for full gospel, but for the nation. Are you with me? The next spirit in this kind of spirit of entitlement. Everybody feels they're entitled to there. No, I bind that spirit in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Listen, you are what God says. God will cause men. You bring men to help you. People will help you. God will help you. The Bible said the people that know they are God shall be strong and do exploits. You will be strong.
Amen.
I said you will be strong. And you will do. You see, that's why I always say, I call it, what do I say? Hashtag know God, hashtag be more, and hashtag do more. It's a pattern. Until you know God, it's like prayer. You cannot, you see, most people, we cannot sacrifice by prayer that which you do through disobedience. Am I making sense? You can't come and stand and bind and loose when you are not doing the right things. Amen? Come on, say amen.
Amen.
God will help you. Amen. Amen. And then say after me, submission precedes resistance. What does the Bible say? Submit to God. Then you can resist the devil. But you know what many of us are doing? Satan, I bind you. Satan, I bind. But you are not resisted. You are not submitted to God. It wouldn't happen. That's a principle. That's a kingdom principle. So before you pray, you submit to God. Before you ask, you submit to him. You humble yourself. And so we must turn from our wicked ways. This, all this wickedness that we're doing, we hold back money, we hold back this, we hold back. I was amazed when a pastor in Ghana here, after we finished the service, took me and his entourage to, what do you call the hotel here? I mean, I don't like that. I won't get. But anyway, I just kept quiet. There was about 28 of us. And we sat there. And I said, What are we doing? That's 150 CDs per head. Drinking and
praise the Lord.
In that same church, there were sisters that when they came to me for counseling, they needed help. So I said to him, brother, this should be the last time you're doing this, you know? Because for example, if you, I always tell you, are you married? Start saving.
If you put away 20 CDs a week, in a year you got 1,000 CDs. Put in a deposit on a plot. Start paying. By the time you get married, you have a plot. You have you have some money. So you're not going into the marriage to depend on a man. The problem with you girls that we're still single. Sorry, next weekend I'm having a single seminar. I'm going to talk to you girls. I said I'm going to talk to you girls. You and single, and there's no respect for single parents. The fact this year my wife lost 3 friends, all 50 plus. They've been in the church for 28 years, 30 years, not married. No, not on my watch. I said not on my watch. They will all get married in Jesus' name. I said in Jesus' name. You see, so you got to start raising the bar. All the ladies say raise the bar. Say it again. I was in Accra Mall. I was sitting there. I go there for coffee. And then there's a place called Bacello. They got free Wi-Fi. That's where I go there in Jesus' name. So I'm checking my mail and talking to my son and everything. And this girl. Up and down. I said, what is she doing? So I said, you know, have you lost something? No. I said, what's your name? She mentioned her name. I said, what do you do? Level 200. I said, I didn't even know what level 200 meant. So, I bet she does, you know, poor vote. She says, no, also I'm a law student. So she says, I said, good. So I said, well done. Like, seriously, uncle, Zah. I said, these are our future lawyers, Zah. I said, sit down. She was fed. I said, sit down. Abban, Bunny, sit down. Abba the Fanta and Coca-Cola. She was getting a bit frightened. I said, listen to me. You want to be a law student and you can't even express yourself? Do you have a thesaurus dictionary? She didn't even know what a thesaurus dictionary was. In Ghana, what nonsense are we doing now? And these are the future leaders. I said, no. Go and before you buy your Brazil and Peru, go and buy a thesaurus dictionary. Learn one English word a day, a year. You'd have got 365 new words. Your vocabulary is not the same. Your confidence level is not the same. You can come and say, Zah. I said, do you read? She said, I said, get yourself some Shakespeare books. Read them. Because law is about interpreting. If you don't have a habit of reading, you're waiting for a prophet to say, kind Jesus. Nobody can pray for your educational success. We can only pray for God to give you a sound mind. That's all. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
Am I making sense? So you need to do something. The purpose of you being education is to go to school, not to go and braid your hair. Hello?
Hi.
I'll close with this testimony by my own son. I'm saying this because I thought God didn't do me good by my one time. I thought he's like, oh, I've been punished. Look at home. Even my younger brother, Benji. You saw him with his daughter. Our last one, I remember he went to school. But you know what? I'm enjoying it. Akraps. I call them Akraps. See the name Silalis you couldn't pronounce there? He's the only one in the world. My mother is called Priscilla, and my mother-in-law is Elizabeth. So I took the Liz from Elizabeth and the Silla from Priscilla and created a name for my daughter, Silalis. Google it. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
That's how God will bless you.
Amen.
So now I've seen that there's a difference. I'm matured now. So I don't know whether I'm making sense. Yes. Look at the input I've put in my son. Why? Because now I'm wiser. So it wasn't a waste of time. May you never be ashamed.
Amen.
God will never put you to shame. Amen. Abeku did something. Two years ago, I wanted him to come home, to come here to see what I'm doing. Guess what? 3 days later, he calls me. He says, Dad, are you going to come back? I said, yeah, I'll be coming back for Christmas. He said, oh, good. Then, you know, Mr. Khan, I should go and put it down on the land. I said, but I manage him. He says, 1,000 CDs, was 1,000 pounds was the ticket. I should use it to go to a real estate people at some place. He says, Dad, you go to OEB? And there, I hear land in Ghana appreciates 38% at 14. Telling me about how land appreciates. So his ticket money. He knows I'll come home. He says by the time he finishes university, he wants to own 10 acres of land in Ghana. Are you listening to me? When I was 14, I was chasing girls at Wesley Girls. You see, am I making sense? Times have changed. Be like the sons of Issachar. Understand the times and the season. Begin to make some collateral, not damage, collateral investment in your own life, in Christ. Because with God, all things are possible. So you start, sorry, I'm not picking on you, but I notice all the young girls, they're just all over the place. When we go to our old boy network, I see all these young girls come. So I thought one of them was their, I thought it was their daughter. So I was showing them Celeste's picture. This is your sister. Your father and I were mates. Do I not? I didn't know. Me, I didn't know. There was some of my friends would pull him out. Chalo, baby. Chalo. we know this will be communication. You're wasting. Don't waste your life. Don't waste your time. Pick up, add value to your life. Don't hang out with people that are not adding value. Go to places where important people are. Can you imagine you want to get married and then you hear there's a concerto by Bach? Then you see the people that go there at different level. Not, oh, single. Come on, say amen. Amen. Come to a full gospel breakfast meeting. Look good. And when you step in, for you to be in full gospel, another level. Amen. Come on, give the Lord. Amen. 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 My daughter Kukwa wants to be a doctor. For the last 8 years, since she told me, she's 15 this year, every year I buy her something, stethoscope, anything to do with doctor. Now she's joined junior doctors. She's part of it. They don't even know she's 15. She's joined the junior doctors. It's an online thing, and she's learning. Holidays next week, this year on half term, she's going to Cambridge. The club is meeting. In England, that's what they do. If you want to be a doctor, they hook you up with. Do they do the same here? No. Hey, Yehovah. No, they do so that they kind of mentor you slowly. Even if you change your mind, you still have learned something. I think we should start it. Come on. Yeah. So it's just, it doesn't affect your time at all. They just WhatsApp you, ask you questions, and you just guide them. So when they're about to choose their subjects and things, apart from the career, Charlie, what's wrong with our nation? I think we've got our priorities mixed up. Anyway, that's something. Education is vital, health and education. And so, girl, I'm not picking on you. Forgive me. I'll say five Hail Marys. But I don't know why God is picking on you today, but it's for you. Do you understand? I dare you. No, I prophesy to you that in the name of Jesus, in 4 years, by the time, are you married yet? By the time you get married, you would have a land, you would have everything. So when the man that is coming would match, hear what I'm saying to you. You follow what I'm saying? You sound mind. You are stimulating him intellectually. Not that your husband, you want to marry a bank manager. He won't take you to cocktail. Hello. No. Before you get to the cocktail, you know about banking. Oh, how are you interested? He's proud of you. Am I making sense, ladies? Yes. So do that. All the men say, I'll raise the bar.
I'll raise the bar.
Say it one more time.
I'll raise the bar.
I will delay gratification. We spend unnecessarily. Just because somebody is wearing a man, you go and spend. Don't do that. Don't be moved by what others have. Do you understand? I said when I came, and then my auntie go again. They want to prove to somebody. One of them died on the site. He collapsed. Cardio, stress. No, don't stress yourself out. God will guide you.
Amen.
I said, every man here, God will guide you.
Amen.
Where I failed, you will succeed.
Amen.
Where I had 1,000, get 10,000. Let my pain be your gain.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Learn every day.
Amen.
Because in life, there's a quadrant. Everybody say the quadrant of life. Stay to love. Say it. To love.
To live.
To learn.
To learn.
And to leave a legacy. Every one of us, we're called to love God with all our heart and love our neighbor as ourselves. We live well. We live by faith. We trust God every day for everything. Faith is a lifestyle. You cannot have faith one day and not have faith the next day. Or your lifestyle. Every day. You came here by faith. What makes you think that you won't get an accident? It was the mercy and the grace of God.
Amen.
That's why it's not him that willeth or him that runneth, but it's God that showeth mercy. You learn every day. I learn every day. I don't know it all. No, I don't know it all. No, I don't. But I learn every day. I learn every day. I learn every day. I make mistakes. I'm not a God. I'm his servant. I'm his son. You follow what I'm saying? I make sure people don't look to me. They look to God. Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. Today, you've turned pastors into surrogate fathers in Ghana. You don't even respect your own parents. May God deliver us all.
Amen.
And finally, you leave a legacy. The legacy you want to leave is not material. It's the impact that you leave, the seed you leave in your children. Trust me. Trust me. Trust me. The seed you sow in them, the seed you sow in your children, the quality of life you teach them, the value of God that you give your children, that God first. If there's nothing at all, teach them there's a higher power than you and God first. Would you stand on your feet? Hallelujah. You know, I could go on and on and on and on and on, but that's not the point. My life is a testimony to you. Are you with me?
Yes.
I pray that something I said stirred you up. Something that I said stirred you up. God is about to raise a generation. And I'm glad that the full gospel have heralded that. Through prayer and through repentance. You see, say you're repentant. When we repent, God moves. Trust me. Every time I make a mistake, I sin, whatever, and I repent, something better happens to me. I remember I had a terrible row with my wife. I was parking, mean drive or car. My wife is like, you wouldn't want to know my love song I sang for her on our wedding day. Oblayoko. That's okay. It was interesting. And I parked. She was, you're going too close to me, honey. Because me, when people, somebody cross me, another believer, let's stop getting, you know what I do? Come, could cross me. Instead of insult, I say, you are blessed. Instead of saying what you don't want to say, I say, you are blessed. Jesus. Jesus' name. So I was just reversing, and I flipped. Oh my God, I flipped. Oh brother, I flipped. I said, what am I doing? What am I becoming? My ego wouldn't let me say sorry instantly. Just slammed the door. And she was just doing her thing. You ladies there, she was filing her nail, watching me. Obina. She asked whether I finished. I didn't know what she meant by that. Obina lo. So she says, I'm the leader. Where I lead, she follows with the children. So are we going to service? I said, what else? I became like Sarkozy. What's that? What else? So we climbed to the service. And then you see these assistant pastors. Charlie, they will shut up. Man of God, our pastor, our general overseer, the man who God. I said, so when I went to pastor, I can't preach this morning, guys. Oh, I didn't behave well at the car park. I'm sorry. The church, but from that day to today, my church respect me so much. Because if you're not willing to accept the mistake, how dare you take the glory? Don't be ashamed to repent. I said, don't be ashamed to repent. Because God is about to do something in our nation. But God, it's through people. Some of you walk out of this place, just one conversation will turn your life around. Just a conversation with somebody, just one. A contract, something you're waiting for, you'll get it. A promotion, a job raise, whatever. Because of Jesus. I want you to close your eyes and raise your hands. God is a good God. God is a merciful God. He will forgive you. He will have mercy on you. Whatever you have done, known or unknown, I want you to speak from your heart. Ask God to bless you. Don't be ashamed. Don't care about who's next to you. Even if he hears it, so what? Ask God to have mercy on your life. Ask God to have mercy. The Bible says, not him that willeth or him that runneth, but it's God that showeth mercy. Let the mercy of God abound today as we repent. That heaven would answer and revival will begin from you. The revival is not just spiritual, it's transformational. But our lives will be different. Man of God, you will walk into a place and the glory of God that will be upon you will be different. It will be different. You're walking out of this place. You open your mouth and you say, hey, is that me? Because God has touched you. God, the Bible says God will search our heart to give us. May God search your heart. May God search your heart. May God search your heart. May God search your heart today. May He search your heart. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We're going to also, I'm going to pray for any person here. There's some doubts in some people's mind. That's dangerous. There's some fears. That's also dangerous. The Bible says without faith it's impossible to please God. So God, fear is the opposite of faith. You fear of the unknown, fear of the future. The year is coming to an end. Many of us are getting jittery. Whether we've achieved something, I tell you something, do not fear. I said do not fear. In England, the most dangerous time is Christmas. Because people think they can't come home because they haven't got papers to return. His mother died, he never saw the mother. But you, God will bless you. Lift up your hands and I pray, Father, let their faith arise. I pray for faith to arise in them. The Lord, as we prepare to bring the year to an end, Father, I pray for 1,000 times more blessing. I pray for 1,000 times more blessing. Let it fall upon them. Let it fall upon us today. In the name of Jesus, bless and sanctify us. Separate us. Transform us. In the name of Jesus, restore us the years that the conquer worm has stolen. And most importantly, elevate us. Everybody say transformation. Shout with passion. Say transformation. Say restoration. And say elevation. God will transform you by the renewing of your mind. God will restore the years that the conquer worm stole. And God will elevate you. Come on, say amen. I said God will elevate you. In the name of Jesus. The elevation is in the spirit realm. And so wherever you walk, wherever you step, the glory of the Lord will be upon you. Wherever you your foot shall step, the glory will be upon you. And favor shall be your portion. In the name of Jesus. Right now, as we stand, you've never experienced Christ as your personal Savior. Listen to me. It's a relationship. It's not a religion. Trust me. Yesterday I was asked on radio about religion and all that on Joy FM. And they're having issues with religion and people's common sense. They're saying that people don't have common sense. Listen to me. When you have a relationship, you don't need common sense to have a relationship. When you're attached to God, all things will work together for your good. So if you don't know Jesus, lift up your hand as the keyboard player brings us to a close. Lift up your hand. If you know Christ and you sometimes you doubt, you want to reconnect with God, raise your hands. I've been there before. When sometimes you think, listen, this thing, I don't think I can make it. I want you to raise your hands too. I'm going to pray with you. Because I've been where you've been. I've sat where you sat. I'm like Ezekiel. I sat where you sat. Jesus says he became sin for all of us. Lift up your hands. If you're here also and you've never, ever experienced the power of God in your life, I want you to raise your hand. God will do it. It's not me. It's not me. It's not me. We believe by faith that his presence is here. That's what we do. As for us, we only work by faith. We believe by faith that his presence is here. In the name of Jesus, raise your hands if you want it. Raise your hand wherever you are. I'm not going to call you forward. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless and sanctify the hearts and the hands and the minds of those who have communicated to you, even in their own silent way. Search their hearts. You said in Jeremiah that you search everybody's heart to give. Father, search their hearts and give them. Bless them. Cover their families in the blood of Jesus Christ. I pray for their future. I pray that the rest of the year will be the best of their year. In the name of Jesus. That this Christmas will be their best Christmas yet. In the name of Jesus. There will be peace in their hearts. There will be peace in their homes. And there will be peace in their minds. Amen. Finally, we're going to pray for this chapter. I want to see explosion in this chapter. I said I want to see explosion in this chapter. Oh, come on. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. I want to see explosion in this chapter. This chapter will be an example in the name of Jesus. Listen to us. Listen to me. In the next few weeks, everybody say, teach one, reach one, teach one, and bring one. Can I say it again? Each one, reach one, teach one, and bring one. Mr. Biney and the team have made it so simple for you. You pick up the book binder, the book, whatever. The voice and the other one. The little slip we have about our aim. Yes, take it. Take it to work. You'll be amazing. Your boss needs Jesus. The greatest gift you can give your boss is salvation. Don't post. Don't try and impress him. Impress him with the gospel. He'll respect you. He'll respect you. The story is told of a woman who cleans Mark Zuckerberg's office. A woman has been a cleaner there for 25 years before he even took the office. Before he Facebook came there. And this woman, every time she's been witnessed, you know these black Americans, nobody knows. He's singing up and down. And then every time he sees Max, he didn't know who Mark was because he's always wearing a t-shirt and jeans. So you should be witnessing to him. You, young man, you need to know you need Christ. You need Jesus Christ. Then one day he gave Mark a flyer and a tract like that. They should come to a program, a revival in their church. Mark was, he just went in Los Angeles. Then he just went to the program. There was only white man there. The, you know, black American church. The pastor was huffing and puffing. The man just sat there. You know, it's like because he's a white man, one sinner, he was preaching directly to him. Sin, sin. And then it was offering time. And then he signed the check for $1 million and put it in. And the pastor said, anybody, God is not mocked. God is not mocked. Because he knew his congregation would never put this about 20. So he said, God is not mocked. God is. And so when the first time is blah, blah, like we do, he still didn't know who he was. So he took, they said, he says, the check will clear. It will clear. Well, the check cleared. The bishop bought the car first. So $1 million. What am I saying? You never know what your boss needs. A man walks in the church, stands at the back. The pastor calls him forward. What kind? Who are you? I came to see Christ. Amen. Pray for him. Next week he comes. Says, pastor says, what can you do? He said, I'm a youth worker. Said, okay, the youth. You take the youth. Because every pastor wants to give the youth to somebody. He took the youth. They came back to pastor. Pastor, the youth have problems. They have got legal problems. And they can't pay legal fees. I want to go and study law after a couple of years. Oi! Before that, he said he wanted a car. The pastor stands in front of the congregation. Church, the youth minister wants a car. That made the raise $2,136. Took it all, gave it to him, go and buy a car. Bought a car, started the work, you know, doing the rounds. Chicago is a very horrible place to be a youth pastor. I want to do law. He didn't choose no meme school, he chose Harvard. 54,000 church, they didn't raise all the 54, they raised about 30. When he got in, he gets a scholarship. He starts. He finished the school, came back. Pastor, I need a place to internship. It's like Africa. The pastor said, last week, Madam Virginia's daughter, she's become a lawyer. She has her own chambers. That lady was Michelle Obama. You never know who we are witnessing to, who is coming to full gospel. In our lifetime, we are in the history of Abraham Lincoln. In the last 18 years, people saw it happen. How God has progressively, they ended in the White House. Who knows that one of us will end in Flagstaff House. Do you understand what I'm teaching you? So it's not him that willeth, but him that runneth. But it's God that shows mercy. Everybody scream mercy.
Mercy.
I want to close with my project. 2 years ago, I suffered a heart attack. Yes, twice. I was just driving, picked the kids from school, and I felt uncomfortable around my chest area. The doctors know. Me, I didn't know. The night before, on Tuesday, mommy doesn't cook in Jesus' name. For the rest of our life, she would never cook on Tuesday. It's a day off, so we go to curry or Chinese or takeaway. It's just my way of saying, hey, Jomoy. And so I thought it was a curry we ate that I got heartburns. Not knowing I was suffering, you would. So when I something to me just drive into the A&E. Yeah, I drove myself. Bam! When I got there, I said, listen, I'm feeling, this is not in my, unease, an uncomfortable ease. I'm not sure. Because my anadine, I swallowed. I thought if I take the anadine and painkillers, it'll be okay. It doesn't happen. The whole day at the office, I was sweating unnecessarily. Cold England, I was sweating. He said my BP was 250 over 171. They tore my shirt, gave me some big injection on my. I said, and guess what? I didn't feel it. I was good. I didn't know I was dying. I would have died to go into glory and happiness. Because but something happened. The lady was mopping the floor, you know, those orderly. She saw me on the stretcher and she WhatsApped to friends and Facebook that I was dead. So breaking news, Pastor Buckman has died. My wife was lecturing. She didn't know what was going on. The church, the students were quiet. Not knowing they seen it on Facebook that I've died, and they didn't know how to tell her. So they were not listening. Look, you see how life can mess up? Long story short, they took me to John Ratcliffe, the heart center, where the first heart transplant and all that. I don't know. Honestly, if I tell you I knew what's happened, I didn't know. So this guy drew some map on my head. He said, "Oh, sir, it's Indian dance group, but he was trying to cut me." He said, "Well, you know, it won't be long, sir. We'll take it here. We'll take it here. We cut here. We break your rib." And then I said, "I'm gonna need you to break me." And I said, "No, I want to see my wife. I want to see." But as I lay there, something happened. I had a voice. I asked myself, if I should die today, how will people remember me? When you die, people only have one sentence. He's a good man, he's a bad man. What would Abiku do? My father died when I was 11. Am I also going to die when Abiku is 11 minus him? No, this is not happening. So it's like a conveyor belt. The doctors know what they just, after they cut, you go. This one cut, you go. I say, hey, they came to my tent. Still my wife hadn't showed up. It was my Cape Town boys. I want me to prepare warriors. They were just wrong. But man of God, you ain't gonna die, you know. But as the Bible said, that's not when you tell me Bible say I know. Man of God, you pleased. You know South Africa. I said, you pleased? Man of God, you pleased? I said, yes, I know. Just shut up. Find money for me. I just want to talk to my wife. Because I'm supposed to sign some paper. And I just wanted her to be there. You know, scared. But I have to show Metro. And I'm just there. And this man was washing his hands. Some man in bow tie. This Englishman. Yes, gentlemen, what are you here for? I said, they say I'm having a heart attack. So don't you know yourself? He says, I can't be having a heart attack because I won't be talking like that. So he asked the guy to do another. Yes. Whatever. The guy would not, was being difficult. Eventually, when they did it, apparently it was wrong foot. What do you call that thing? It wasn't quite much for him. No, X-ray. He said I had four arteries blocked. That's my X-ray. The X-ray was a Beckman, a 70-year-old Englishman. His name was Beckman, and I'm Buckman. Mine is, yes, block, 1.5. I said, God, just going to cut me. See, I was here, doctors to do. Why would you jump? I said, no. And so the man, thank God for the man. The prophet, I thought he's the head of. Because I was rather interested in this sports, you know what? I said, I'm the head of the department, young man. But I've just pioneered something called the stent. He started something, the stent. So he rather put the stent in there than put the smoke. So what you tell me? I wouldn't be able to preach again because it's not as easy as the Indian man was telling me it sounded. Not knowing that when they cut you, he gets 48,000. Anytime they do surgery, they get paid. So I didn't say what you something to quiet what you tell. Because the more we tread, the more we tell one cow. So they did it. But here, when I left the hospital after a few weeks, they gave me a t-shirt. And on the t-shirt was written, I love my heart. And they told me that they all came to my church for the celebration. I didn't die. So the professors, all the nurses came and they said to me that they believe that my next message is going to be about teaching men how to live, Not long, the NHS, I became the ambassador. Because the Ghanaian community would die more than any community in England through hypertension. You know what it is. Mortality has doubled. So it's whenever you hear that, but it's my voice telling brothers. In Ghana, I came there drinking Red Bull and Joy Bitters. And all, those things will kill you. And just little habits. So after years of fighting over my mother's property, and I tell them where Jesus lives, I'm not going to live there because there's too much control. My spirit is not right to live there. I want to turn it into a cardiovascular stroke center for free, 24 hours a day. I've already bought the PCO stuff, but I'm trying to get it organized. My mother died 25 years in August. For her 25th anniversary, I want to open that because my friends, Bob Hoxton, every year about 3 or 4 pastors die on the pulpit. Haven't you noticed that? So many young men are just popping or die. I want to be an ambassador of that, helping men. That we've got to live in. How many of you can say amen to that? So if you want to sow, come and see me after. The place is in a salon. My daughter did some slippers. I'll give you one. Silla organized them. It's in that bag. My daughter commissioned some slippers that anybody that sows, we should bless. Her brand is Silla Rock. Silla Rocks. She wants to help me because I told them they will not die. So Abeku's not as big as I am. He watches what he eats. He exercises. Yeah, that's it. She commissioned it and used her name. Any person that sows to daddy's project, I must give them one of these. And she's been helping me. She gave these guys iPhone and laptops to help train. I've gotten them all involved because it's their future. God bless you. God bless you. If you're after the service, come and let's talk. Raise your hand. Let me finally bless you.
This is a demonstration of Wirecast.
Maybe we may not meet again till next year. It's only 8 weeks away. Is that right? About a year, a few weeks. It's about 8 weeks to the end of the year. Listen, dream a new dream. God will help you. God will help you. God will help us. This country, we are the country. So if we are right, the country will be right. It's like the church. We are the ecclesia. We are the called out ones. This year, as we end the year, may God visit you in your sleep, in your dreams, at home. May God visit you. May God protect your family. May God give you health. May He give you wealth. May He give you wisdom. I cannot leave here without asking some of you, if you're not members of the full gospel, I'm proud to be a member of the full gospel. I wear the badge everywhere I go, everywhere I stand. I don't know, my other suit had it. The lady that, you know, it's the lady that sold this for me in Kepos. Her whole hope was gone. She's become an alcoholic. She could sew. But she's, life didn't just do it right. So I told her, get up. So now she's promised to keep me. Every suit I wear, she that when I went to go to England, when people like it, I say £150. So they send her money, got a money transfer. And then she shows and puts it in FedEx and brings it. Last, to date, she's sold 32 suits since I first introduced that to people. This is how we help you. This is what the full gospel stands for. So if you're here and you're not a member of the full gospel, won't you raise your hand right now? We will make you a member in the name of Jesus. God will open a door for all of us. As God blesses us, so would He bless you too. Do you understand? So if you're not a member, are you a member? Who's not a member? Raise your hand if you're not a member. Come forward. Come here right now. Come here. As for you, your wedding, we are all coming. Come. All those, come on, run to me. Seriously? Come on, run. Oh my God, look at you. Hey, Allah. Aha. There's a shake. Shake it. God bless you. Welcome. Well, give them a hand, everybody. Come on, give them a hand. Are you a member? I like your nose. Come on. Hallelujah. Listen, it's the happiest people on earth. Trust me. You, what we said yesterday, you won't hear it from the Pope, would you? Like, seriously? you wouldn't hear it. But this place, we're happy. When we're happy, when you're happy, we're happy. Is that right? We're just happy. We don't judge you. We want to be with you. We want to be part of you. Girl, you know that? Are you glad you came? Well, listen to this man. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Those of you can have your seat. And full gospel is just turn my life around. It will help you to do what God brought you here to do. God did not bring you here to become an engineer and doctor for nothing, but He left you there so that He will draw people to yourself. When I started full gospel, I knew that is the place God has for me. And we are the happiest people because we have found what God created us to be, to call men back to Himself. I just promise you, if you join this fellowship, you will never regret. I mean, you will find that peace that surpasses all understanding. This is just to assure you. Just pick a membership form, fill it and give it back to us. We will pray for you. No matter the challenges you go through, the Lord will be with you. I'm telling you this because as soon as you join, you might see things might initially go a little bit rough. But don't give up. Don't look back. But just know that we are here to support you. Just to run this race. It's a long race. But God will be with you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We give you all the glory and the honor. We worship you for this opportunity. We thank you for these new members who have decided to join us. We pray that you always be with them. Guide them. Let your angels always be around them. When they pass through the waters, let's be with them. When they pass through the fire, it will not burn them. I pray for the work they do. I pray for their family. I pray that they will find fulfillment in this fellowship.
I soak them in the blood of Jesus, and no weapon formed against them will prosper. We give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. God bless you. Congratulations. 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 God bless you. Congratulations. Congratulations. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Doc. The name is Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship, but nevertheless, we have women among us and they play a very key role, especially in moments like this where we would want to show our great appreciation to Doc Charles Buckman. I would want to call Auntie Paula Adumyeboa and Auntie Kukwa. Auntie Kukwa, please support her for me, please. I would want to have them do us the honor and present our food basket to you, Dr. Charles Buckman, please. Put your hands together for them as they come. I appreciate them, please.
So, good morning to all.
Morning.
On behalf of the OSU chapter, we wish to extend our sincere gratitude for taking time off your busy schedule to come and share your testimony with us, encourage us, speak to us. And I'm sure we've all learned a lot from him. We have enjoyed it, and we will look forward to having you again. This is just a little appreciation from us to you, so just to say thank you. So like that. So thank you so much. We are very, very grateful.
Yeah, I mean, with a trolley, I get what you do. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You're not single, are you?
This is a demonstration of why
I want to. No, mine too can come. Thank you so much. I hope I was a blessing to you.
Okay.
Stay in football. Stay here.
Thank you very much. Thank you. God bless you. A quick short announcement. We have books, you know, powerful books which will change your life at the book table. Most of the books from our own very own Pastor, God bless, they are all on the table. Yes. I would also want to invite Mr. and Mrs. Saki forward. Today is 1 year they got married. Today is their 1 year anniversary. Can we have Mr. and Mrs. Saki coming forward? Let's appreciate them. Uncle Bob, can you please do us the honor by praying with them for us, please?
Of wire.
Good morning. Please hold hands. Hold hands together. Hold hands together. Let's please let's get up. Let's bear them up in prayer. Let's pray for them. Heavenly Father, Maker of heaven and earth, I commit Mr. and Mrs. Saki into your hands. Heavenly Father, their marriage was brought before you. You blessed it. And Father, what you have put together, no one can divide it. Heavenly Father, we pray for good health. Father, we pray that they are develops into a friendship. Our Heavenly Father, we pray that you bless them with the fruits of marriage. Heavenly Father, Holy Spirit, be the third party of this marriage. We thank you. We give glory to you. Father, once again, we thank you through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you very much, Uncle Bob.
please also do remember that first Wednesdays of every month we have a prayer meeting at Coconut Grove Regent Hotel. So please do well to attend at 6 p.m. every first Wednesday. And then also every Tuesday we meet, Osu Chapter, we meet at Gap Presbytery, also at 6. So you're also all very welcome. And then we would want to see you every Tuesday at Cuckoo Hill. Yeah, that's where it is. Can we have also if you're here late, you didn't come in early, and you didn't put anything in our envelope, please I just want to remind you that we'll be glad if you can do that for us. Put something in the envelope and then drop it at the table for us. We have a very lovely brother and a wife here who would want to say something to us, so if we can have them, they will introduce themselves and then I am not introducing you, so please introduce yourself. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good morning. Okay, we are Mr. and Mrs. Nathaniel Anastasia Coleman. We got married a month ago, and and our lovely family, the Full Gospel Businessmen Fellowship International, also chapter of which I'm a member and is soon to join, came in their numbers to support us. And one thing I love so much was that a Friday before the Saturday our wedding, the president called on behalf of the chapter. And by then I was down, things were not going well. And he said, Nat, don't give up. If he has started with you from the beginning, he will end it with you. And things turned around, and God's grace, everything went successfully. So we are here today to thank God for his mercies, to thank the happiest people on earth, of which we are a family, and to thank this chapter and members. And we say, a year by this time, you too have a testimony. Amen.
Thank you very much, Mr. and Mrs. Coleman. I would want to call our coordinator, Mrs. Saki, to give us a final and closing prayer. And then a prayer for the nation as well, please. Put your hands together for her.
Okay, please, may we be all on our feet. And Lord and Master Jesus, we thank you so much for a time spent in your presence. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for the message given to us. We know, Father Lord, you will work in our hearts. The words will stay in our hearts, Father Lord, as we are leaving. We are not leaving your presence. We pray that you continue to guide us, lead us, and order our steps. We are committing our dear country, Ghana, into your hands. But Father Lord, have your way in this country. Father Lord, come and lead us and teach us. Father, we need your wisdom to run this country. We pray that you continue to guide the country, continue to lead us. In the name of Jesus, have I prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. The grace, please.
This is a demonstration of
the final one. His banner over us is love. His banner over us is love. His banner over us is love. His banner over us is love.
I think